first met Dr. King, who read his war reporting on Viet children's suffering. Martin asked young William Pepper to speak about the war, to come to his congregation, and they were friends forevermore. Then William went to law school, put his talents to the task, to fight for social justice, to answer questions we must ask. It was April 4, 1968, when Martin Luther King was murdered in the broad daylight. It was a devastating thing. There was a mighty rush to judgment, to blame it on James Earl Ray. There was agreement in the government to tell the media what to say. The media called it a crime of hate, a lone nut simple thing. Now we know it was an act of state, the execution of Dr. King. James Earl Ray was just a patsy, an escaped prisoner for sure, with a top security identity for the whole 9 months before. Some rogues within the government shielded James's Eric Galt, gave him a car and a driver's license to secure him till the assault, to protect this petty criminal, to put the patsy into place. His handlers sent him to Memphis, where like a pawn he showed his face. Well, Martin marched for civil rights, and he stood against all war. He spoke for truth and justice and nonviolence for sure. When Martin stood with the workers in solidarity with the poor, that high-class oligarchy hated Martin, that's for sure. Earl Clark was one of the Memphis cops meeting at Loyd Jowers' grill, across from the Lorraine Motel where Dr. King was killed. Two military sniper teams would have also fired if the police team from Memphis failed to do what was required. Next day, cops cleaned the crime scene, hauled the brush and the proof away. They avoided all the witnesses that might have some truth to say. Too many unanswered questions still blowing in the wind, murder investigation so deliberately ruined. Too many disturbing answers still came out in the trial, enough to prove conspiracy to a nation in denial. Six white and six black jurors unanimously agreed the facts presented at the trial proved who really did the deed. As it all came out in trial, that in 99 they won, when the government was convicted of the conspiracy they'd done. William Pepper was the lawyer who won the case in court, but when he went to the press conference, no reporters came to report. So here's to William Pepper, King family brave and wise, standing for the truth for us, for overcoming all the lies. William Pepper, keep on struggling, you know you're following the teachings and the vision and the dream of Dr. King. William Pepper wrote a book about the trial and everything, an act of state, the execution of Martin Luther King. Act of state, the execution of Martin Luther King.